Hello, 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 hello. This is Dirty Trucking. Out here on the streets of Detroit, in my usual location, the bus stop, waiting on the freight to take my ass home, because I'm tired. What a day I have. Hello to my fellow truckers, OTR, Lease Purchase Company, those in training, still green. Let me tell you about my day. I felt like I was over the road again. Come into work, thought everything was going fine. Had the truck warming up, tarping the trailer, get back in the truck. What the fuck is this on my dash? The deaf little red light is on, and my truck is on a 4-hour countdown to a D-rate. I'm like, what the fuck just happened here? All I did was crank it up. That deaf shit in these trucks needs to go. I don't know what idiot in the transportation industry set up and decided that we should put cow piss mixed with water in a motherfucking truck and thought it wasn't gonna be no goddamn problems. That shit has been hell on every truck. I lost the truck because of that shit. Had to pay out a lot of money to get that system fixed. And it broke down again where I lost my truck and all the money I invested in it. Death is some horrible shit. The shit smells bad. When it leaks on the side of the trailer, leaves white stains. The shit fucks up your truck. I don't know who thought diesel needed some help running through the truck to run the truck. That shit fucks up a truck. Everybody, every truck that has that shit, the system has been fucked up. That shit costs a lot of money to get fixed when it messes up your system. So, evidently, I must have got hold of some bad death here at our own yard. And it fucked my truck up. The mechanic tried to clear it out. He got it cleared. And told me to go ahead and take off with it. Try it out. I ain't even make it down to 275 on the highway. And the goddamn countdown popped back up. Now I'm counting down from 3 hours down. I said, ain't this a bitch. So I went on and decided to go ahead and dump the load. And go get back to the yard, so it shut it down and you just swap me in something else. I get up to the goddamn landfill. Here we go again. I'm in line behind all these motherfucking Canadian trucks up there dumping. I ain't never seen no shit like this before in my life. We on the U.S. side and I'm in line for about an hour waiting to get a tipper on the U.S. side behind all these Canadian trucks. I mean, it's just a shitload of them that comes to that landfill. It's two landfills we go to that they be at. And I haven't been to the other one in a while, but this one I went to, this is another one we go to. Nothing but Canadian. I mean, they just took over. I'm like, we just, like, when I'm up there in my truck with a load, getting ready to try to get on the tipper, it's like I'm a visitor or something. Shit, these motherfuckers done took over and shit. All you see is Canada, Ontario, Canada, Canadian. God damn. So, by the time I made it in line for the tipper, was next on the tipper, my D-rate clock had then counted down to 1 hour. I actually made it on the tipper, got it tipped. I said, let me go get some fuel, because if you had to kick it into a regen, he's going to have to do a forced regen again and let it complete to see if it fixed it. So, I said, let me get some fuel, because that forced regen is going to burn some fuel trying to clean that shit out of there. But death is the worst shit ever. I would like to talk to the person that come up with this shit. What the hell was you thinking? Do you know the problems that has caused these trucks because this shit is on there? Get this shit off these damn trucks. We don't want to put that shit in there, and that shit is fucking up the truck. That is some shit mixed with water. That shit at the fuel pumps and the pilot and doves, that water mixed in there is not right. And I've had the most problems with my trucks when I fueled at the Loves or Pilot or T8, get that damn death out the pumps. That shit fucks up your truck. It never fails. I mean, it's horrible what it does to a system. It would cost a It would cost you thousands of dollars. That shit cost me over about $7,000 in repairs, and they never fixed the damn problem. And the truck broke down again, and I had to leave the truck. I had the truck 2 years. I would still be at USA Truck. USA Truck. If that shit didn't happen. In my black Kenworth, T680, Big Daddy. If that shit hadn't happened. All that money. See, that's where they get you. They know what to do to trucks and put on trucks to get the money out you. That shit is fucking up the trucks. And the government, the transportation industry, the trucking industry, you need to get that shit off of there. Get the shit off the trucks. Get the death off the trucks. These trucks don't need that damn shit. That is the worst shit ever. All you did was found something else that we need to pay for to add with the fuel to get the truck running, but then it's costing us thousands of dollars when the shit fuck up the truck. Never did I think at this local job, and this is mighty funny, every truck I get, shortly after I get the truck, I start experiencing these damn death problems, similar to what I had over the road. Like somebody was doing this shit, because the damn ain't me. I'm not doing the shit. Why is it every truck I get into got to have a death problem? Ain't nobody else had death problems. The driver that had the truck before me, he didn't have no death problems that I know of. But they said that truck was put in the shop or something. Why is it every time I get a truck, I start experiencing some unusual shit? When I had that other local job here, I had just got assigned the truck. All I was doing was cleaning the truck. And the goddamn death shit came up. The truck needed to go to the damn shop. I was cleaning it. All I did was look back at the dash, that light was on. Just like I was doing here. I was tarping the motherfucking truck. I get back in there, get ready to take off. It's increased derating 4 hours. What the fuck? Now, I run the load, I get it back, get the truck back here, pulled in the yard with 30 minutes before it was actually finna derate. Shut it down. But the saga doesn't end. See, this is why I don't like local, because you deal with raggedy trucks. Replace your fleet. Quit trying to run them raggedy-ass trucks. Fix them raggedy-ass trucks. Run them till they just fall the fucking apart. Now, the next truck I get in just to get me going. This truck is an older truck. Raggedy, rustic, but it ran. The damn thing takes off like a fucking turtle. You got to put on the gas about 5 seconds prior to you thinking the light finna turn green just to get it ready to go. And then when it's ready to go, it act like it's shifting a half a gear and not a whole gear before it finally gets up to speed. I'm just sitting there, fucking 12 cars and people on foot then went past me before this damn truck got up to speed. Now, when you get it on the highway, same thing. Don't let me come off a ramp or change the ramps, get in a different direction on the damn highway. Same speed. Like I got 12 fucking axles and shit. And when it do get up to speed, okay, the sucker's smooth. It's smoother than my new truck. My new truck needs to have some work done up under it. Look at the axle, because it's riding a little rough. But this truck, for raggedy, it was smooth. If it could be such a thing, a raggedy smooth truck. But the damn thing's slow. It takes off like a turtle. See, this why, you know, when you used to luxury, it's a shock when you go back to something raggedy. When you open the door and just see all that dirt and shit. Though I'm dealing with landfill trucks, so we expect that dirt and shit. Excuse me for looking off, because I gotta try to make this video. Oh, never mind, my freight coming.